Good morning, MCOM final. So we are here because of a special circumstance. We all know that we are studying from home. We have been giving you all the PPTs and notes regularly. So I hope that you are going through the notes and going through the PPTs and going through the Zoom classes that your teachers have been taken at consistently at equal intervals of time. So today our topic of discussion is strategic analysis and choice. A bit of it has already been covered in class. So we will do what? We will start by revision of our topic and then we'll proceed further for the topics that we haven't covered in the class. So starting with strategic alternatives and process of strategic choice. So here what we'll do is we'll cover first the corporate level alternative strategies. Now, what is strategy formulation or what is situational analysis? Now, strategy formulation is often referred to as strategic planning or long-term planning. The strategy formulation process is concerned with the developing a corporate mission, objectives, strategies, and policies. This process involves scanning the internal and external factors, analysis of the strategic factors and generation, evaluation and selection of the best alternative strategy appropriate for the analysis. So business has to select a strategy that is best for it. It has to come up with strategic choice. It has to come up with strategic alternatives and then make a process a very technical and a very structured process of strategic choice. A business or a firm that is able to do a good strategic choice is able to succeed in the competitive market. So coming up with strategic alternatives, what we have is our different kinds of strategies. Namely, we have stability strategies, growth strategies, retrenchment strategies, and combination strategies. So a part of it we have already covered in the class, so I'll be going through them. So the main topic of discussion is evaluation of our strategic choice, making our strategic choices. So these are strategic alternatives that we are going through right now, because to understand the process of strategic choice, we need to first understand the strategic alternatives. So different strategic alternatives that are available to the firm are these. Starting with the stability strategy, it states maintenance of status quo. That is, this is a sustainable growth strategies. Some firms adapt this stability strategy by attempting to maintain their size, level of production and sales, serving almost the same customer group, performing the same customer functions, and continues to remain in the same business line by using the same technologies. So here the firm is satisfied with what it is doing. It does not want to make a major change in its strategy because somehow the present strategies are working for the firm. Coming up with growth strategies, organizations may select a growth strategy to increase their profits. This is the growth strategy. So organization may select growth strategies to increase their profits, sales, market share. They also use the growth strategies to reduce the cost of production per unit. So how do the companies go over with the growth strategies? That is, they go with the strategy of internal growth. They have a strategy of concentration. They do mergers, takeovers, acquisitions. They go in for horizontal integration. They go in for conglomerate diversification. They can go in for vertical integration, or they can even go for joint ventures. Now, among these, we have already discussed all these topics in the class. So I'll be particularly discussing these horizontal integration and vertical integration. Horizontal integration, as we have already, we know there's an example that when two firms are in the same level of operations, when they merge or when they integrate, that is somehow called horizontal integration. And in case of vertical integration, when you go vertical in a supply chain management, then one firm acquiring the firm above it in the supply chain management, or one firm acquiring or merging with the firm that is below it in the supply chain management, or integrating, we can call it a merger or acquisition or integration. So that will be a vertical integration. Conglomerate diversification, we have a very good example of ITC, a company which is in conglomerate diversification, always looking for growth, always looking for growth strategies. Then coming on to this retrenchment strategy. So retrenchment strategy is somehow the turnaround strategies. A company that is looking for turnaround, a company that is looking for when the firm position is disappointing or survival is at stake, then the retrenchment strategies are appropriate. And in case of turnaround strategies, it is about improving the internal efficiency. This can be done by adopting turnaround strategy. It aims to transform the firm into a learner and more effective business. Coming with to captive strategy, the strategy is pursued when a firm sells the majority of its products to one customer who in turn performs some of the functions normally done by an independent firm, that is by reducing the labor cost or size of the employees. Then we come to transformation strategy. In this case, the firm makes a major change in its outlook and operations, including moving from one kind of business to another. In case of divestment strategy, the company sells or spins off one of its business units. Under this strategy, the company sells off its business units because it does not want to be a part of this business anymore. In case of liquidation, this strategy involves closing down a business organization and selling off its assets. Then coming to combination strategy, this is also called as portfolio restructuring. It is a combination of various strategies we have already discussed. It is a combination of stability, growth, and retrenchment strategies. This is a kind of integrative, this combination strategies would be an integrative model of the strategic alternatives. Okay. So, this was about your grand strategies. These strategies are also known as grand strategies. These four strategies are known as grand strategies or corporate level strategies. Then next we have generic strategies. Now generic strategies are important because these strategies include all the moves and approaches a firm has taken to attract buyers, to withstand the competitive pressures, and to improve its marketing positions. So these are generic strategies. I repeat, generic strategies include all the moves, all the approaches taken by the firm to attract three points. First, to attract buyers, to withstand the competition or competitive pressure, and to improve its marketing position. Okay, so coming to first strategy, which is a generic strategy, it is a low-cost leadership strategy. So, a low cost leader's basis for competitive advantage is the lower overall cost than the competitor. So, the firm's aims to have a lower cost as compared to all the competitors, thus gaining a leadership position in the market. So, the purpose of this low cost leadership strategy is to fix the price of the product at the lower level as compared to its competitors, to gain maximum share from the competitors, and to earn high profit margins. Next, coming to differentiation strategies. Now here, generally the customer's needs, taste, preferences vary from one customer to another. These differences can be satisfied by producing the products with different attributes. Competitive advantage or competitor's advantage results when more customers become strongly attached to the attributes of the differentiator's product offering. That is, you differentiate a product based on its quality, based on its features, based on its price, or any kind of differentiation. So how you differentiate yourself in a competitive market is basically a differentiation strategy. So it involves the studying of customer needs, tastes, preferences, and everything that you need to study. Coming on to focus and specialization strategy. Now, focusing is very important. It begins by choosing a market niche where customers have distinctive tastes and requirements. The strategy's basis for competitive advantage is either lower cost than competitors in serving the market niche, or an ability to offer niche kind of a product or service that is very different from the competitors. So it will both have a focus on niche market and a focus on specialization. So this strategy is a very nice strategy. It can be adopted by the products which might be luxury products, which might be less available in the market, which might be of demand to a lesser set of customer. So this was the part that we needed to do before coming to strategic analysis and choice. Now, a company or a business needs to make the choice. Now, what does it need to do? Because the strategic choice is essentially a decision-making process, so to make a choice among alternative, a decision-maker or a marketer has to have certain criteria to accept or reject the alternatives. These criteria are selection factors. Strategic choice could be defined as, now the, what is the definition of strategic choice? I am coming to the definition of strategic choice. It could be defined as the decision to select from among the grand strategies. We had done the grand strategies in the first or second slide I told you. Consider the strategies which will be best to meet the enterprise objectives. The decisions involves the focus on a few alternatives, considering the selection factors, evaluating the alternatives against these criteria and making the actual choice of the alternatives. So, starting with the most popular kind of matrix is BCG matrix. BCG is also called as Boston Consulting Group matrix, as we can see. So this matrix is rather very important. I'm not sure that how much time do we have in this screencast. So I suppose we have a kind of 2 or 3 minutes to go on these screencast. So I'll just give you a overview of what we will follow in our next screencast. So in strategic choice and alternatives, we will be covering Boston Consulting Group. We would be covering this G9 matrix, G9 cell matrix, and we would be covering directional policy matrix. So we would be covering these three matrices, which are very important in case of strategic analysis and choice. So we kind of finish this over, and we will be switching to next screencast for the further discussion on these very PPTs. Thank you.